Yo, what's good, y'all? Back with another one. I'm just chilling, you know. Just got done watching the fight with Ryan Garcia and Javier Fortuna. Like I was saying, yo, like that was the best Ryan Garcia has looked in about 2, 3 years, yo. Like he looked sharp, he looked focused, his combinations were right. It's kind of funny that he finally gets away from Eddie Reynoso and he actually looks like a solid fighter now. 'Cause he didn't look good. Even though the last fight with Homeboy, he didn't really look that good, but that was under his first fight with Joe Gusek, so I'll give him a slight pass for that. But he didn't look good against Lou Campbell. He didn't look good the other fight before that. So like he was regressing under Eddie Reynoso, but that's the pattern with Eddie Reynoso fighters. They regress under him. Like that's just straight up facts. Like it ain't no debate about it. People regress under Eddie Reynoso, aka Canelo, aka Oscar Valdez. That's why Frank Sanchez left. That's why Andy Ruiz left, because they were regressing under him. Like he don't make adjustments during a fight. That's the problem with Eddie Reynoso. Like he don't make adjustments. He depends on the fighter to make adjustments. And then he fucked around to get all the credit. Like, come on, bro. Like, it don't work like that. But that's a conversation for another day. Bottom line is Ryan Garcia looked sharp tonight. Like I said, that was the most impressive I've been with Ryan Garcia in years. Like, no debate about it. What's next for Ryan Garcia? It's all about Tank. Like, and I just saw Tank's tweet responding to Ryan Garcia. He said, "Let's get it on at the end of the year." So hopefully Floyd and Oscar can come together and make that fight happen. I'm cool with it. I ain't got no problem with that fight with Tank and Ryan Garcia. But congratulations, Ryan Garcia, on a very good performance. But let me get back in here, man. I'm gonna holler at y'all. Peace.